Hello there, this is Emily Mick. Welcome to this YouTube tutorial on how I made these bases for my Sisters of Battle. Here are some minis I need bases for. There's a squad of retributors and sacrosancts. Here is also some examples of bases I've made before. Some of these are really tough to balance the miniature on, but I try to make new bases better in that aspect. This is an example of the concrete rubble I'm making in this tutorial. Here is the mold. It's made of plastic cards and half round plastic strips. I also used half orbs. If you want to magnetize your models, it's easy to do before making the rest of the bases. Like on Morwen, I used two-part epoxy glue. It was a bit too messy, so I started using epoxy putty and super glue instead, like on this orc. I'll show you this step because it's part of my basing process, and I thought to include some tips on how to make the magnets stick. First, I scrape, sand, and clean the underside of the bases to make the glue and putty grab the plastic better. Then I mixed the putty. I used standard yellow milliput because it's quite cheap. When it's completely mixed, I rolled a sausage. I counted that I have 16 bases to magnetize, so I divide the milliput sausage in equal parts. I used these old paint pots as miniature holders while painting. I've glued all the magnets on holder same way, so I'm using this one to know which way to glue the magnets below the bases. The magnets I used for this are 5x3mm N35 magnets from Green Stuff World. I roll a ball of putty and super glue it to the base. Then I sculpt the putty on the edges to have bigger surface against the base. Then I add another drop of glue and then the magnet. After that, I press the base on a flat surface to make it even. I stick it to my fingers here. Now to the main subject of this video. So this time I decided to use these old blister packs as the mold for the concrete. The purpose of the mold is to create different flat surfaces and shapes. I also used the same plastic profile and half orbs that I had left over from the other mold. The mold making have many possibilities to be creative. Clear plastic is good for tracing geometric shapes by using the help of cutting part below. I drew this grid so I could place the orbs aligned it more easily. I made another mold with the half round plastic rod. I mark where I want to glue them. These strips will create the recessed details in the concrete cast. To make the rebar inside concrete, I twist 0.4 copper wire. I just use the pin vise to twist the wire. This is the end result. It isn't exactly reinforcement bar, but close enough. I cut it in lengths that fit the mold. Then to the casting. I use this concrete that's meant for hobby and craft projects, like making concrete decorations. There's instructions on the measurements. I just mix 1 tablespoon of water to half a deciliter of concrete. You don't want to add too much water because the concrete might be then left brittle after curing. I use these measuring tools only for this kind of thing. It's not wise to use the ones you use for baking. I mix it even and pour a layer on the mold. Then I spread the concrete to fill the corners. After that, I add the rebars and press them lightly in the concrete. And add another layer on top. It's easier to mix more concrete as you run out than having too much. Just be careful not to contaminate concrete powder with a moist equipment. I did the same for the other mold and sprinkled some leftover rebars. It doesn't really matter how fancy the rebar structure is, because only the parts where it sticks out will be seen. It takes over 24 hours for the concrete to completely harden, so you need to break it before to achieve more realistic results in this scale. I took the concrete out of mold about 3 hours after casting. I use a pointed tool to break the surface of the concrete and super glue where I don't want the broken parts to fall off. It is still a bit too soft, so I let it sit for a while longer. If the concrete starts turning back to powder easily, it's not set enough for this step. Here it's after another 2 hours of curing and me being impatient. You can't really control or plan how the concrete will break, so I just try to use super glue every time I see interesting damage that would look good on the bases. I cut the rebar wires where they are sticking out too long. My goal here is to break slabs of concrete that will fit the 32mm bases and have enough flat surface to stick the models on. It's important to have a lot of flat surfaces contrasting the broken sides. Otherwise, the concrete will just look like rocks. If the ratio of water and powder is correct, the concrete will not be brittle when cured. Now that it's fully dry and broken, I picked all the good pieces to work as starting point when building the bases. I use PVA glue to attach the concrete to the bases. I first try to create surface where the model can be glued on. Also, adding medium-sized concrete parts to frame the bigger slab. I also add some smaller pieces at the same stage, leaving still some empty surface to be filled when this has dried. I use the models to see how they would stand on the bases. You can create dynamic looking poses by having slanted surfaces. By adding different sized pieces of concrete, you can make the bases more realistic looking, and it also creates interest. You could also add some other stuff like skulls or boulder shells. A great way to make shells is using brass tubing. Since PVA takes a while to dry, it's easy to remove pieces that you don't like. But you also need to be careful not to move the ones you have placed while adding more. This is how the bases looked after first round of adding concrete. Then I add more glue and sprinkle the small rubble to the blank spots on the base. And here are some cool time lapses. To secure the dust and rubble, I mix PVA with a little bit of dishwashing liquid and water, so that the glue will flow to the crevices. Here are the finished bases. Drilling the concrete is bad for your drill bits, so if you need to pin a miniature on these, you can scrape a hole and fill it with milliput. After that's dry, you can pin the model like I did here with this white metal miniature. I always use super glue to stick the models on the bases. It sticks really well between plastic and concrete. If you would like to see more content like this, please consider liking and subscribing. Thank you. And thank you for watching this tutorial.